Okay. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Shirley Stock, the ultimate concert in the park. Shirley Stock is going to be amazing. I even wrote a song about it. Shirley Stock, Shirley Stock. We're gonna have a great time at Shirley Stock. It's gonna be amazing with Sid, cause she is the best pop star in the world. It's not very good, but I'll fix it later. Today, our main event is the one and only Sid. You know her, you love her. Sid will be out here to sing her hit song called Peace.
I can't wait for the concert. I want to get as close to the stage as I can get. Oh, me too. I'm going to sit right here. No, if you sit there, I can't see anything.
You'll just have to get over that.
But I want to see Sid. I'm her biggest fan.
No, I'm Sid's biggest fan.
So sit back. Relax. Oh, hold on. I'm getting a phone call. Excuse me just a minute. Hello?
Hello, Grandma Shirley. This is Sid.
Hey, Sid. Where are you? The concert's about to start.
That's why I'm calling you. I got in a little quarrel with my limo driver.
A quarrel?
Yeah, a quarrel. An argument. A fight. A tiff. A squabble.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, during an argument, my limo driver took the wrong turn. And now we're lost.
But you're supposed to be on stage in just a few minutes. What am I supposed to do? Your biggest fans are here.
Just stall. I'll be there as soon as I can. Sid, out.
Oh no! What do I do? I've got to stall. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, are y'all excited to see Sid?
Yeah! Woo! I'm her biggest fan.
No, I'm her biggest fan.
I know the words to all her songs.
Well, so do I.
We want Sid! We want Sid!
Okay, Sid will be right here. Don't you worry. Just sit back and relax. Somebody help! Can anybody help? Does anybody have any talents?
I got talent. I know some jokes. You want me to tell jokes?
Perfect. Go up there and tell as many jokes as you can.
Okay. Hey, folks. How's it going?
Hey, you're not Sid.
We want Sid. It's okay. Sid will be right out here. In the meantime, I'm going to tell you some jokes. Listen up. I'm hilarious. First joke. Joke number one. Why do bees have sticky hair? Because they use a honeycomb. Oh, come on. That's a good joke. I'm funny. Okay, joke number two. What do you call an elephant in the telephone booth? Stuck. Get it? Because the elephant would be so big and the phone booth would be...
What's a phone booth?
Ugh, I'm funny, I promise. I better be getting paid for this.
Oh, no. This is not going well. Hey, maybe play a game?
A game? I don't know no games.
Just make something up.
Okay. It's game time. I got these three paper airplanes. We're all gonna take one and throw it in the air to see which airplane flies the longest. You kids at home, pick which one will fly the farthest. The white one? The yellow one, the pink one. Are you ready? One, two, three.
Man, I really wanted to win.
Well, I'm Sid's biggest fan.
I deserve to win.
No, I'm her biggest fan.
No, I am.
No, I am.
No, I am.
Oh my goodness, the crowd is getting restless again. I need someone else to help me stall. Excuse me, do you guys have any talents that can help me stall until Sid gets here?
We're musicians.
Why are you saying...
You're saying magic weird.
You're saying music weird.
No, it's... The person that does magic is a magician.
Yeah, but we're not going to do magic.
We'll help.
Well, I don't really care what you do. Just go up there and stall for me, okay?
Hello, everyone.
Hi.
We're going to sing you a song.
Make some magic tricks is what we're going to do.
I don't think it's a good idea to do some tricks. We're going to sing a song.
First, ladies and gentlemen, I am the great Nadini, and this is my assistant.
Assistant?
Yes.
No, sorry. We're going to sing a song, and this is my backup singer.
And we're going to do the magic tricks, and he's my assistant.
Hey, Shirley, I helped you stall. Are you going to pay me now?
Paid? I never said you'd get paid.
What? I don't tell my jokes for free. Those are premium jokes.
But nobody even laughed.
If you're Sid's biggest fan, what's her birthday?
Easy. It's June 23rd. If you're her biggest fan, then where was she born?
Easy. Bucks North, Tennessee. But she grew up in...
Ding Dong, Texas.
For my first trick, my assistant will... My assistant...
I want my money and I need it now.
I don't have any money to give
you. This is a song I wrote back in my good old days.
If you hold it just like so, then if you hold it like this, then ta-da!
Well,
it's a different instrument now, if you didn't notice.
Anyways, this is a song of
Michael Rowe.
I don't have any money to give you.
Whoa, Grandma Shirley, what's going on over here?
I'm trying to have a concert for my friends, but it's all just falling apart. Everything is out of control.
Well, maybe I can help. Ladies and gentlemen, listen up. I got a story for you. Who here knows who Abram and Lot are?
I know.
I know, too. I've always known.
Settle down, everyone. Take a deep breath. I can tell that y'all are all arguing, but listen about a story of two men and how they solved their differences. In the Bible, a man named Abram was leaving the country of Egypt. He had a bunch of stuff, cows, gold, silver. He took all those things with him, along with his wife Sarah and his nephew Lot. Lot had a bunch of stuff too. Now, the people who were in charge of Abram's sheep and the people who were in charge of Lot's sheep, they began to argue. There wasn't enough land for all of them to share. So in Genesis chapter 13, verses 8 and 9, it says, Abram said to Lot, "Please, let's not have quarreling between you and me, or between your herdsmen and my herdsmen, since we're all relatives. Isn't the whole land before you? Separate from me. If you go left, I will go to the right. And if you go right, I will go to the left."
So Abram knew there was a problem, and he thought the best thing for them to do was to go their separate ways?
That's right. He gave Lot the choice. Lot looked out and saw this place called the Jordan Valley. It was a very nice place to live, and it reminded him of Egypt where he had just come from. So Lot chose that place, and Abram went the other way.
Was the place that Lot went better than the place that Abram went?
It was, but Abram knew that it was best for them. He was willing to give up the nice land in order to bring peace to his family.
Wow, that's quite a sacrifice.
That's right, and God honored his sacrifice. God told Abram that his family would grow and get big, and Abram wouldn't be able to count all of them. Abram trusted God. Now, do you think it was difficult for Abram to let Lot choose which land to go to first?
I think it was really hard.
The Bible doesn't tell us how Abram felt about Lot choosing the good land, but we do know that Abram did not want his family to argue. Abram gave Lot his choice of land so that they could all live in peace. And in the end, God blessed Abram with even more land and the promise of a big family.
So being peaceful was more important than getting exactly what you want.
Like if somebody wants to do magic instead of singing a song, maybe it's just best to do a magic trick. It doesn't matter.
Or if someone wants to sit closer to the stage, it's better not to get upset about it. It's better to have a friend than to get your way all the time.
That's right. Jesus told us that people should be peacemakers. In Mark 9:50, Jesus told his followers to be at peace with one another. And another time, Jesus said, "Blessed are the peacemakers." Jesus was even called the Prince of Peace by the prophet Isaiah.
So when our life is full of arguing and chaos, God wants us to be different by bringing peace to chaos.
That's right. It isn't always easy to live at peace with people, but God wants us to work out our differences. This week, you can choose not to argue with your parents, your siblings, and your friends. Work together to find a solution to the argument. Remember to think more of others than yourself. And follow Jesus' example to live at peace.
You know what, Pearly? You can have this seat.
Thank you.
I'm probably the best magician in the world, but I think today I'd rather hear you sing.
Well, maybe I can sing a song while you do a trick.
My jokes were the best ever, but I guess you don't gotta pay me. I was being greedy.
It's okay. Oh, look over there! Sid's here! Miss Kathy, thank you so much for teaching us how to be peacemakers. You stalled just long enough for Sid to get here. Now it's time for the concert to begin!
Hey y'all, sorry I'm late. I got in a fight with my limo driver, but we realized we needed to work together to get here. So I apologize, and now I'm here.
Sid!
I'm your biggest... We're your biggest fans.
Great. Well, now I need your help to sing this song. It's called Peace. It's a song based on the Bible verse Romans 12:18. Sing it with me, everyone. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Live at peace with everyone. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Live at peace with everyone. Live at peace with everyone. Everyone. Live at peace with everyone. It is possible.
Yay! Good job, everyone!
I see it! Hooray! Shirley Stock is a success! I'm just gonna have to do this every year. It seems like everything went a lot better when we stopped arguing with each other. You know what? This week, you guys can try and be peacemakers in your house. God doesn't want us to be mad at each other. He is greater than any problem or fight. If you find yourself in the middle of a fight, just do what we did. Take a deep breath. And remember to try and think about the problem from the other person's point of view. Instead of arguing, use kind words. Let someone else have the last piece of dessert or choose what show to watch on TV. Putting others' needs first takes practice. But with God's help, you can love your family and learn to think of others more than yourself. Well, I'm gonna go enjoy the rest of the concert. I'll see y'all next time.
That's it.
Come on, Sid.